Hi friends, how about a little stretch it out? I'm out here on fresh cut lawn that my husband just did, and with all the bumblebees flying around, as well as my Yorkie Sam, who are probably joining us actually right now. So anyway, we're just gonna take a few minutes to take some stretch and just kind of relieve any stress that may be in your shoulders, in your neck, and in your legs, and just take a few minutes to stretch it out today. And it is perfect weather outside, not too hot, the wind's blowing, and I'll be able to hopefully give you just a few moments to really rest. I know the visual part of this may not be the best, and but at least you can see what's going on and just take a few moments to treat yourself to a nice time just to relax. Actually, kids can enjoy this, husbands or whatever, and so I'm going to start some music and we'll get right into it. So hope you enjoy it. It's going to be good. Okay, Sam, let's move over to one side. Shoulder back and away from your ears. Just nice, gentle rotation of the shoulders back. Just waking all of that up and saying, it's time for me. It's time just to relax just a little bit. I know, Sam's going to be with us throughout the whole thing, so I don't think you'll mind. Let's drop the ear to one side. Just a gentle rotation of the chin to the chest. And ear over to the other side. Let's do that several times, just back and forth. At your own timing, you want to go slower, you want to go a little bit faster, whatever feels good to you. You take your eyes, shut them. I automatically do that with me, is just shutting my eyes so that I can feel actually where all that work is going on in my neck, where I carry a lot of tension. But it's just a good time to be outside. Weather could not be more perfect. And we could be all sneezing as well with all the pollen that's out in the air. Let's take it for a spinal rotation. Just small circles. That's all. Just waking up your spine so that we can stretch. Just a little natural move. And if you are, do this outside. Even later today or whatever, or repeat it tomorrow, that could be possible as well. Let's reverse that rotation from one side to the other. Great. You know, in my own practice of exercise, because I get to teach stretch, I've really learned to enjoy it a lot more than I ever did before. Take both hands. I'm going to turn to the side so you can see. Keep your palms behind you. Your fingers stretching out. And just press your chest. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Kind of push your chest out. And just glance upward. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Perfect. Bring both of those arms around to the front. Drop your head towards your knees and round out the back. Just do that again. Bring the hands to the back, palms away from you. Just gently lifting up the chest. Control your neck, not dropping it back too far. Just looking up, and I'm looking up and seeing lots of bumblebees everywhere. Take those hands back around to the front and just a hug. Good stretch through your back, down through your spine, through your lat. Great. I'm going to turn back towards you again. And this time, just take your legs out to just as wide as you feel comfortable. Take your hands here, roll the shoulders back. Pull your core in, just kind of going to zip up the front, and then relax your shoulders. So we've got core stability. You're going to take your right hand up, lift it up over top, and just reach just as far as you want to go. That first initial stretch, Just take it easy. Not too far, not too deep. Always remember your breath. And we'll switch over to the other side. Same thing. Reaching. You know how far you can go. And back. Take your fingertips. Walk them out on the floor. Yeah, and then just gently drop your head between your between your hands. This is the great part. Can't edit it and all that sort of stuff, but hey, that makes it even more fun. Let's walk those fingers in again. This time walk both hands on either side of that leg and just reaching for the toe. If you can grab your toes, great. If not, stop here if you need to. But if you can grab your toes and underneath your paw, your arch or your foot, I'm trying to stay within range so you can see. I may have to scoot back and forth. And now breathe in and exhale into that stretch. And just walk your hands right back up to the top. And let's do the same thing. Walk your hands out towards your foot. I'll shift again. Grabbing either your toes from inside your foot, or your calf, or your knee. You just find that place. But I want you to breathe, inhale, exhale, and relax. The breath helps us relax our muscles, and you become a part of that. Let's bring the feet together. Take a deep breath. Inhale, and just forward fold. Yeah, feel the back of those legs. And once again, you only go into the range you feel comfortable with. And a breath outside of your feet. Or if you're more comfortable, just staying right here at your knees. Breathing in and exhale will help relax so that we can take those stretches just a little bit deeper. And begin to roll up through the vertebrae, pulling the belly button in toward the spine. Take a good deep breath, inhale, exhale, and forward fold once again. And rolling up, just one vertebrae at a time. Great, let's bring our feet together. Pull them in just as close as you feel like you can. Clasp them. And we're just going to gently pat the knees down toward the floor. Again, keep your shoulders back. Feel that really good inside those inner thighs, those adductors. Keeping the shoulders back. Core engaged. I think I lost my friend, Sam. He wasn't center of the presentation, so he said, oh, no, I see you peeking out the door. Here he comes again for a little bit more. All right, bring those knees up. Let's take it into just a flat on the floor, supine. I'm making a soup bowl right here. So I want you to inhale. Pressing your spine to the mat and actually making an indention. Ah, yes. Now release it. Just press your belly up toward the sky, the ceiling, wherever you may be. Great. Pulling that belly button down into the floor again. Just making an imprint. Like we're out on the beach today. Making the imprint in the sand so that you can see every vertebrae that is imprinting into the sand. And release it, pressing your belly up toward the ceiling. It's just a very slight arch of the back. Not so much that you sure don't want to feel pain. But do that again. Just a little bit of a rotation. Pressing your belly button in toward the floor. as though someone has a thread all the way through the belly button to the floor and really pulling it in. And then relax just to a neutral spine. We're going to dip one knee in towards your chest and release. Same thing with the other. Knee into the chest. Now let's do that several times. One knee at a time. Just take your time. We sure don't need to be in a hurry. We've got plenty of time to stay at home. Isn't it great, though, that we have tools of technology that we can do things like that with this and here when we're all at home and still staying somewhat connected, especially to our gym time family? Great, let's go back. Grab that one knee, and then I want you to take your bottom leg and just extend it out. Yeah, see if you can pull that that knee just a little bit shoulder closer toward your shoulder. And now let's extend it up toward the center. Take your hands right behind your back. Calf, hamstrings. And let's point and flex. Great. You feel that gastrocnemius working for you right there. And now just circle the foot around. And reverse that. Great. Flex the foot. And this time, walk your hands up the back of your leg, either to your calf or holding it here. You can keep your head staying on the ground if you prefer. Let's see how close we can bring that top leg to our upper body. Everybody's range of motion is different, so no judgment. Great. Bend that knee again. This time, lay back down. Shoulders are onto the floor, and then take that knee to the outside, like an external rotation. We're just stretching that adductor again. And now I want you to take that knee and just circle it outward, just for an external rotation from your hip flexors, quadriceps. Great. Hold it here. Roll gently over onto your side. Grab the top of that foot and pull your foot towards your hiney, towards your bottom, your glutes. Stretching the front of your quadriceps. At this time, you're also balancing yourself. So it's a good time where we really do know that our core is engaged. And now let's roll back on our back. Bring that bottom foot, ankle on the knee. And just lift up that foot off of the floor. You'll feel the stretch in the outside of your hip, and I'll do it on the other side in just a moment. Take your hands, weave it underneath. And gently pull that leg just a little bit closer. Back leg comes up toward the ceiling. And for those of you that want to take that even deeper, we just lift the upper body off the floor. I think Sam's getting hot. He's going in. Good. Lower the upper body back down and bring both knees in. Let's rotate those knees while we massage our low back. Remember your breath. Good steady inhale, exhale. And now reverse those knees. I love this because this is when I really feel that I'm activated in my core. I can actually feel myself being stable. Great. Now we're moving to the other side. Sit on the floor, knee in toward your chest, and just hug it as much as you feel comfortable hugging. Now lower the bottom leg out on the floor for a full extension and take that top leg either behind the calf or behind the hamstring, whatever you choose. Let's point and flex. It is getting warm inside. Point and flex. Point and flex. And just circle right there at the ankle. And reverse it. I hope you're enjoying the music. I love these guitar meditations. Good. Flex the foot. Bring that knee in just a little bit. And then right straight back up. Walk your hands up to the back. Again, if you want to, you can keep your head on the floor. Or you can bring your upper body all the way up. And just pull that leg in as close as you feel comfortable. You feel that really deep stretch in your hamstring. Are you breathing? This is one place that we have a tendency to hold your breath. Breathe. And now lower your upper body back down to the floor. Bend that knee and take it to an external rotation. Be aware of your core, how it's holding you stable onto the mat. And reverse it. And bring that bottom leg up. Ankle goes on the knee. Lift the foot off of the floor. We can weave your hand right through the center of the leg, staying flat on the floor if you prefer. Or lift it up. And now just pulling those knees in as close as you can to your upper body. Extending the back leg. You want to go even deeper? Just pull it in where you feel like you can go. Remember to breathe. This is kind of hard breathing because we've got everything stretched up together. Lower it down just like we did on the other side. We're going to stretch the quadricep. So I'm going to make a quick adjustment and turn towards you. And you're just going to stay where you are. Grab the top of that foot. You may lay your head down or you can come up just a little bit. There's balance in this, stretching the front of that quadricep. And from here, we're going over to our hands and knees. And just put yourself up on your knees. And your hands are directly up under shoulder. Wrist, elbow, shoulder. Knee, hip. And let's pull the belly button up. We know this as cat-cow. So what you want to do is just get a flow for your own self. And in that flow, let your breath inhale, exhale. Inhale and exhale. We're going to do this several more times. Enjoy it. Enjoy what you feel going on in your low back, through your shoulders, dropping your head, and reversing it up. And one more time. And come back to neutral spine. Look over your shoulder at your hip. So we have a little twist right here, using our obliques. And look over your hip to the other side, your shoulders to the other side. Again, just reverse. Feel good? I hope so. And over to the other side. go back to that neutral spine again. Let me get the hair out of my face. Pull your toes under in the back. And just barely lift your knees up off the floor, keeping a neutral spine. I like this because it automatically all your core is activated. Good, bring the knees back down. Oh, yes, feels good. Can we do that one more time? Great. Pick the knees up. I'm proud of you. I'm glad you're doing it. I don't know, maybe we can meet her several more times. And lower the knees down. Maybe we can learn to get this into our practice. Weekly. Lift up your right foot, pushing it up toward the ceiling, flexing the foot. And now bring that knee in, rounding out the back. Oh yes. And right back up again. Okay, let's do that three times. It's the last one on this side. Now extend that back leg. So if you're on your right leg and it's extended, pick up your left hand and extend it. Hi. Balance. Ear is level with your arm, or your arm is level with your ear. And again, I know that you feel the core activation. And bring that hand down. Remember to equal out wrist, elbow, shoulder, knee, and hip. And then let's pick that left knee up, holding it. Pull it in toward the center. We have three more. Take it easy. Go slow. Are you remembering to breathe? Here's our last one. And now extend that back leg. So if that's your left leg, you want to lift up your right hand. Arm comes level with the ear. Good balance. Are you okay? You still holding? Perfect. Hand comes down. And now let's bring your feet together. Take your knees to the width of your mat or your rug, whatever you might be using. And we're going to push our hips right back toward those heels, keeping your hands where they are. Head comes down towards your mat and feel that nice stretch through your shoulders. Good breath. Inhale, exhale. I'm looking at you underneath. This time, as you pull up, I want you to pull your belly button into your spine as you round out your back. And we're going to go forward just slightly. Ah, strong arms. Push back into that child's pose again. Good breath. Inhale, exhale. Let's hold it here. Breathing in and out. Are you breathing? And come out of that rolling up one vertebrae at a time. Gently push forward on those hands. Oh, yes. And we come back just to neutral. Bring those knees back in. This time, curl the toes under. We're going to go for a downward facing dog. So, gently lift your knees up. Take your hips. Shoot them up toward the ceiling. line your ears and arms up together. Maybe press that chest just a little bit. Let's do some walking. Now, so gently, if you can bring both of those heels down toward the floor. How to do that? Don't overstretch, don't overpress yourself. Great, let's bring it to a plank from right there. Lower your booty. And now bring one knee to the front. This is my all-time favorite. You can stay up right here. I'm going to turn around so you can see what I'm doing with that front knee. I'm walking my leg out, my foot out away from me. And now you can keep it in this position. I'm going to turn back around like so. Or you can put that back knee down, whatever you choose to do. Or up on that toe. Fully extending that back leg. And now we're going to bring the elbows to the floor, only if you want to. Now we can let the knee down in the back. That foot is walked out away from you, like so. Just go ahead and switch. So your foot is out here, back leg's down. Then we can walk it all the way down. If this is too much, you can always modify everything. Again, you can stay up. You don't have to come all the way down. But if you would prefer to, you can. Actually, you can go even further. You want to put your head down. And this is where you can really breathe and relax. I love this. Let me switch back so you can see from the other side. Something really stretching through this gluteus. Time to relax. Come back up to our hands. Pull that toe back under. Lift up just a little bit and let's move that knee back. And now bring the other one forward. Walk your foot out. Choices, you can stay here for a bit or you can go ahead and back lower that back knee. Just a choice. This has really given us a full engagement. Core stability. You want to bring the hands down, elbows down. Again, choice. Now if you want to, lower the back knee. And everybody lower. Flatten out your toe. Choose a place. If you prefer stay in here, remember, always modify according to what you feel good about. We don't want pulled muscles or any kind of real aches and pains. Stretching sometimes when we're doing it for the first time can be really uncomfortable, so make sure you find a place that works for you. But if you want to, go ahead and take it down to the elbows. Just relax your hip. Feel that good stretch on the outside of your hip. And I always tell you, remember to breathe, because in the breathing, that helps us to relax the muscles and really get the maximum amount of stretch that we can out of them. And if you're not there yet, that's okay. One day, just keep working and we'll all be there together. Hands back up on the mat. Curl that back toe under. Lift up just a little bit and let's unfold that knee back to our hands and knees. Great. And this time we're going to bring that foot forward. And this is one of my favorites, all-time favorites, hip flexor stretch. So I'm lined up pretty well. This knee is going to stay just like it is in this angle. So our knee and ankle are together for right now. Shoulders back and down away from the ears. So we're just on our lunge. That's all. We can be there. This time we're going to really stretch out that back leg. Let me go ahead and switch so I'll be directly right on the camera for you. Notice that? And now just gently begin to let that back leg extend. If you need to walk that leg out just a little bit more, that's perfectly okay. I just love the feel right here. It is truly one of my all-time favorites. Now you can stay right here, or you can bring both hands down to the floor on the inside of your foot. If that's really uncomfortable, please stay up here. That's just a place, a goal to go to. So that, and now we're going to let that leg just kind of float out to the side just a little bit. Again, another hip opening, and I'm trying to stay within here, you can see. Okay, there's another level. Only if you want to go there. Elbows come down. Now that out leg is tilted out just a bit. This is pretty deep. Are you crying also yet? Trying to keep a neutral spine, shoulders down away from your ears. You can get both elbows down, great. If not, no big deal. Alright, come back up to those hands again. Oh yes. Push back just a little bit. Now the hands on either side of your leg. And you can go deeper or stay right here. Doesn't matter. Or even better yet, if you need to come up in this position, we're just going to stretch that front leg. How's it feeling so far? Miserable? I hope not. Feels good. Good, let's press that toe down. And now we're just going to walk around to the other side. Just that easy. Yeah. Remember where we started? Oh, yes. I know my head's cut off. I'll be right back with you. Let's lower it down. I know. Walk that knee away from you. Remember that stretch right here? This is where we were. You can stay up, come down. Now, this leg, just let it float out just a little bit. You're not pushing it way out, just a little bit away from your body. Remember, you can stay here or up on your knee. Elbows come down only if you prefer. That leg is floated outside of your body a little bit. Shoulders down away from your ears. Breathe the stretch. And come back up to the palm of the hands. Yeah? Not bad, huh? And let's push it up on that back knee. And now take both hands on either side of your foot. I just have to say, I just thank God for the weather today. How beautiful it is. Now, if you need to come up in this position, remember you can come up here and you're going to have to balance a little bit, pulling that toe up, or if you're staying down, that's good too. Want to go deeper? Bring that top of the head down. You're going to feel the stretch in your hands. Make sure that your knee is staying soft. You're going to lock that joint. You're stretching muscles. Stay right here, but this time hands are on the floor. Yeah. Fingertips. Just lunge it over to one side. Nice and easy. Not forceful at all. I think I'm sweating some now. Walk it back over to the other side. Can we do it again? Just a gentle lunge over the knees. Feel that stretch through the those adductors. And then over to the other side. walk your feet in and then down to your knees, just because I don't have visual, very good visual, to do standing up. If we get to do this again, I'll arrange it where we can stand up. Take a good deep breath, inhale, and exhale. Inhale again. This time, reach both hands up toward the heavens. And we just raise a hallelujah. I'm not ashamed. Let's stretch through the triceps. And with that, we're just going to take just a lat spinal flexion. Right back there. Reach up again. Another hallelujah. Tricep on the other side. And I'm really not calling it right or left. Choose a place. Choose a right or a left. Right back up to the center again. One more raise. Pull the arms down. Squeeze them back. Bring your hands around to the center of your back. And you're going to just bend forward. As you do, begin to lift your hands up. You don't have to go far. Really stretching out through those shoulders. Stay there just a little bit. Great, and lift it back up. Place your opposite hand on the opposite knee and just tap it for a spinal rotation. Just let assist yourself. Going around to the back. Looking over your shoulder. Breathing. Good. Release that and do the same thing on the other side. Opposite hand to opposite knee on the outside. Just give yourself a gentle twist all the way around, looking over your shoulder. And then we come back to the center. Just get another deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. Awesome work, and I hope to be back with you soon. Thanks so much, Gym Time community and family. Stay safe. God bless.